Hey everyone, surrealcanine here. Welcome back for more La-Mulana 2. In the last episode, we didn't find very many items, though we did get a peek at some of the other areas we'll be going to while we were exploring Valhalla. In this episode, we are going to be, we're going to be returning to Valhalla, probably, and checking things out a bit more. Oops. As soon as I figure out where I'm going with anything. Alright. Whoops. Once again, the bat. Okay, what's down here? Nothing I can deal with without some kind of a, you know, cloak sigil. Oh well. Yeah. Not the biggest fan of bats. Wonder if there's an item that insta-kills them, like in the first game. It would be quite handy. So yeah, here we are, back in Valhalla. Let's keep scouring the world for hints and clues. This is interesting. This was, oh yeah, this is where we died last time. Don't know what the deal with that kid is, but I guess we'll be finding out sooner or later. Didn't come back, so. Oh! Oh! Those switches in the ground there are like, well, my mouse won't point to it, but, like on that block in the left, in that block on the left, there's a switch. Those are for the Earth Spear, I guess. That's what the game is trying to tell us. So yeah, we probably do not want to approach that statue without a better shield. What's this tower have to say? Sit, proceed. Oh. Or you can just duck like a normal person. Yes! Ooh, Caltrops. Those will come in handy. Maybe. Probably better for speedrunning than any normal sort of purpose, but you know. Alright. You're making an excellent start to our episode 10 adventure. Whoops. This looks like something I... Actually, hang on, what? Okay, that is the, that was the other gold giant we need, or gold thing we needed to kill. Yeah. Alright, so that means we should be able to fight their father then, right? What's down here? Okay. Future Development Company, the Bargain Duck. Duck who became intelligent through the influence of the ruins. That's just silly. But yeah, Future Development Company was what let us access the backside in the first game. So this is where we find it. Water is slightly poisonous, but we're not gonna let that stop us. I just know these thrones here are gonna serve some purpose to us in a puzzle or something, but I don't know what. Ooh! Vucub Caquix! This is not going very well for us. Let's try that again, but better. Also, maybe using our shurikens for this. Had him too. Oh no! Bah! I got spiked. Not good news for me, that's for sure. So yeah, if you miss with your shuriken, you get zapped. Good to know. Just keep going until we get spiked like an idiot. This is not going very well for us. Dang it. This is the worst thing. Well, what are you doing here, Lamisa? You're going right without me telling you to. There we go. Sheesh. What does that do for us, though? Well, it lets us get down here. For one thing. That opens up that. Dissonance lingers where children of the same seed are in conflict. When calamity that governs conflict disappears, dissonance will be released, and a stone with a face swallows it. Get through there. I guess we fall. Ooh! I got spiked. Still can't afford a future development company. It's just a combo of pain. Yeah. I need to break out the knife. I missed. I don't actually know what's up here. Yeah, where to next? Go up. Here's the quarter of. Interesting. What does this do for us now? Guess we're supposed to be chasing that kid or whatever it is. Very strange. We went down. Doesn't seem to be much of value down here. We'll save my game. After that, I don't know. we been chasing the trickster? Is that what we've been doing? Can't get up there. Ah, I solved the puzzle. Whoops! that was stupid. 4 sigil, whatever. We have 100 coins now, so anytime we're ready, we can go and do a thing. Oh, it's a one-way door. Okay. Shiva sits in the heavens, for when she drops the light that burns the land below. Vishnu sits in the heavens, for when she watches the land below. The two gods fall from heaven over world conflict, leaving behind Brahma, who is relocated to one of Yggdrasil's branches, a primeval entity of many heads and arms, who watches over the world of his creation. Okay. Is that the thing that was underneath us? Could be. Oh, that's a monster. Well, this may be a mystery best left for another episode. Let's say we go get our feature development company. Whoops. Keeps happening. Take a walk on the dark side. That's the achievement I just got. So yeah. With the feature development company loaded, 200 megabytes. We can now get to the dark side of the ruins. So yeah. No more having to trek all the way through a divine fortress just to get into Valhalla. Pretty handy, that. Still, we're still no closer to something. I do wonder what the deal is with this shrine here. Seems to be, here. Maybe it means nothing in this game, I don't know. Then again, if it meant nothing, it wouldn't be here. At least that's what I'm thinking. The vendors, I guess, just do not have a lot to say. What does Zalpa have to say? Yeah, well, your face. So yeah, we're done here. Thank you all for watching, though. I will see you guys next episode. Bye-bye for now.